Morning everybody, my name is Yatha Rishabh Patwa. I am second year MBBS student studying in Dr. Vilas Patil Medical College. So today we are going to study about vitamin D and bisphosphonate. So first we will learn about vitamin D and then we will learn about the bisphosphonate. So what is vitamin D? So vitamin D and other growth hormones, they help in the regulation of plasma calcium levels. So the three hormones are vitamin D, parathyroid hormone and calcium hormone. So we will learn about vitamin D. So vitamin D, it is a multiple term which includes D1, D2 and D3. D3 is the active form of the vitamin, that is D3, it is cholecalciferol. D2 is calciferol and D1 it is present in fermented foods. So vitamin D, it is better to call it as a hormone because it is present in the skin and there is no in normal amount it no need to take from the diet. And it is transported in the blood and from blood it will carry toward the target tissue where it will act through receptors. And third point is feedback regulation of vitamin D. It is by the active form which is the calciferol. So the synthesis of vitamin D. So it is synthesized in the skin as well as in our body via the with the food which we take, that is the diet, egg, bread, butter and all. So the synthesis in the skin, 7-dehydrocholesterol which is present in the skin, in the presence of UV light it will get converted into the cholecalciferol, which the cholecalciferol in the presence of the microsomal enzyme present in liver will be converted into the calciferol, and in presence of kidney, in presence of the enzyme 1-alpha-hydroxylase it will convert into calciferol, which is the active form of vitamin D, and this calciferol it helps in the function of all the vitamin D. So the functions of vitamin D, first it helps in the absorption of the calcium. So it increases the calcium absorption by increasing the calcium binding protein and increasing the calcium channel in the intestine. Calcium binding protein that also called as a calbinding. And second, the vitamin D, it increases the plasma calcium level. So plasma calcium levels are increased by the activity of osteoblast. The rank ligand are increases which gives signals to the osteoclast. So osteoclast, with the help of the referral membrane, it will cause the resorption from the bone, which will increase the calcium in the plasma level, which will lead to the increase in the calcium in plasma. And third action is in the kidney. So in kidney, it will, in proximal convoluted tubule, it will reabsorb the calcium. So these all are the functions. And now, so introduction, synthesis and function is done. Now the preparation. So the preparation of calcium. So 1 microgram of cholecalciferol, it gives 400 unit of vitamin D. So the calciferol, cholecalciferol, alpha-calcidol. Alpha-calcidol, it is a prodrug which is 1-OHD3. So it do not need the parathyroid hormone which for the synthesis of calciferol, because already it is in the active form. So the alpha-calcidol, it will be used in vitamin D resistant rickets, vitamin D dependent rickets and the kidney failure rickets. Then we come toward the uses. So vitamin D, as we studied the function of vitamin D, they are in the kidney, intestine and also bone. So the uses of vitamin D, first one is in prophylaxis of vitamin D deficiency. Then rickets. Rickets are of three types. D-resistant ricket, it is X-linked disorder. So here we will give in high amount, high dosage phosphate as well as calciferol. In vitamin D resistant rickets, we will give in normal dosage the alpha calciferol, because here the formation of calciferol is less. And in renal rickets, there is absence of formation of calciferol, because there is renal failure. So we will give here alpha calcidol or dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone, it is a synthetic analog of D2. It also don't require the PTH hormone for the synthesis of the calciferol, because it directly acts on the bone and it will increase the calcium level in the plasma. So in this way we have completed with the vitamin D. Now we will move forward to the bisphosphonate. So what is bisphosphonate? About the bisphosphonate, they are the analog of pyrophosphate. The pyrophosphate, it is POP. So POP, the oxygen, it is replaced by the carbon. So it is PCP. classification. Classification according to the potency, there are 3 generation: first generation, second generation, third generation. And the first generation, it contains a non-amino, whereas second and third, they contains amino bisphosphonates. So first generation, etidronate; second generation, pamidronate, alendronate; and third generation, resedronate and zoledronate. So mechanism of action. Bisphosphonate, they have the high affinity towards the calcium. So bisphosphonate, it will bind to the surface of the bone, and the concentration will be more below the osteoclast because there is acidic pH. And whenever the calcium will be taken by the osteoclast along with the calcium during resorption, bisphosphonate will also be uptaken by the osteoclast, and it will inhibit the formation. It will inhibit the ruffle membrane which is formed in osteoclast for the resorption. So and amino bisphosphonates have additional functions. They inhibit the prenylation. Prenylation, it is the protein formation which occurs in the mevalonate pathway, which is required for the osteoclast function and activation. Then vesicle formation, which will be inhibited by the amino bisphosphonates. Also, the bisphosphonate, they inhibit the interleukin 16. It is required for the osteoclast proliferation. So in this way, the main function of bisphosphonate from all the mechanism of non-amino as well as amino, it leads to the inhibit the bone resorption. Side effects. All the drugs, they are given by the oral route. The two drugs, that is pamidronate and zoledronate, they are present in IV. So the frequency of dosing will be reduced. So once a year. And why? Because 50% of drug, it is sequestered in tissue. Now coming toward the side effect, as the oral, they are the oral drugs, and the absorption is less. So it causes the esophagitis. So how will prevent the esophagitis? So patient is advised to take the drug with the full glass of water, and take it on empty stomach. And after taking the drug, do not lie down for 30 minutes. So in this way, we can prevent the esophagitis. Other side effects, they are nausea, vomiting, and the uses of bisphosphonate. The uses of bisphosphonate is a first choice drug in osteoporosis, because estrogen, it only reduces the vertebral fractures, whereas the bisphosphonate, it reduces the vertebral fractures as well as hip fractures. And osteoporosis, the second, in hypercalcemia and malignancy, this drug is also useful there, because for anti-tumor effect, there is the inhibition of prenylation, which we talked in mevalonate pathway, is useful here. And the other, osteolytic bone metastasis. These all are the uses of bisphosphonate. So in this way, we conclude with the vitamin D and bisphosphonate. Vitamin D is a hormone which helps in the calcium regulation, whereas bisphosphonates, it inhibits the bone resorption. Thank you.